Yet another Louis Vuitton Unboxing. Hi and very welcome. My name is Mary, this is my channel Lumi Level Up, and I'm a luxury lover on an average income trying to be more mindful with my money. We have a little jump in time here. I filmed a part of the video, the major part, right when I received the package and unboxed it. But since I didn't make a plan what I wanted to tell you in that video, it kind of felt incomplete with just showing you the unboxing. But now, looking back, I think everything I showed you in that first video take would have been enough for a whole video, but I didn't take a thumbnail picture and I didn't film an outro, so there are missing some small parts that I do take right now, and that's why I'm here again with some more introducing words. I put on the same earrings and the same vintage Celine vest, but it's still a totally different look because I'm not wearing the turtleneck, so clearly you can see it's another day of recording. And I'm going to give you a little bit more information about the unboxing you are going to see the Mary of the past doing. It is, I think I put it in the title and the thumbnail, a Louis Vuitton clay, so a key holder. And as we all know, they are super hard to get right now. So luckily, I wasn't hunting for the classic canvas ones in monogram or damier, because I already have all of them. But I was searching for something more special to me and more vintage, which is, when you are honest to yourself, more value for money than the clays are now. But don't get me wrong, I still think they are a great item and, yeah, still kind of worth the price. I love the clays. But the one I got did not even come in this orange box, it's from another one. I just couldn't find the brown box. Oh, now I spoiled. I couldn't find the box the item came in after I filmed the first unboxing part, so I had to improvise now to have something for the thumbnail to hold up. So here's the orange box. Okay, but if you want to know what kind of clay I got from Louis Vuitton, how much I paid and all that stuff, just keep watching because I'm giving back to Mary of the past now. Peeling off the shipping label, because that's the thing YouTubers do. I cannot wait any longer, that's why I just have to do the unboxing. I don't know what else I have already told you, but let's just do it to see it. The item is pre-loved. It should be in very good condition. The seller even said it was never used. It should come with the packaging and the invoice. So, yeah. Classic Mary. I ruined the open thing. Happens to me most of the times. Yeah. Okay. This is so exciting always, because usually, of course, you focus on what's inside of the box, but when you film an unboxing, you try to show the camera, to have the camera see what you see with you together. So, okay, we have Vestiaire Collective paper, and it's a teeny tiny box, and it's one of the old boxes. I already thought it would be an old box since the item is not available anymore. And I think it might not have been available for quite a while now. The box looks like quite good condition. Here is a little red mark, but it's possible that I did it with my fingernails right now. Doesn't bother me. Maybe I was it myself. Who knows? Yeah. Pre-loved Louis Vuitton with a box in brand new condition. Oh, you know what's interesting? There's no invoice, because this box is too small to fit an invoice. Am I bothered? Usually I like it a lot to have the invoice, because if you ever decide you want to resell it, it's way easier to do so with the invoice. Guess I'm at least going to write and contact Vestiaire Collective, because I don't care so much for this item, because I'm quite sure I'm never going to sell it, but there's missing a piece. But let's hope everything else is as mentioned as in the description. Do you already know what kind of item it is? I think it's not too hard to guess, because it's very small and it is a very typical shape. Wow. It's a key clay in vernis patent leather. And I think because it's so dark outside now, it might look nearly black, but it's more of a maroon Bordeaux color that is called
Amaran.
As mentioned, it really looks like brand new. Check the glazing. There are no signs of wear at all. Let's check it from the inside. No scratches at all on the hardware. And since it's so dark, it's quite hard to see. Okay, it's a made in Spain piece. And where is my phone? I need some more light to check the data code. It is from, not sure if it's a 7 or a 9. I have to check tomorrow with daylight. I think it's a 9, 2007, but maybe it's 2009. The piece itself, it is pristine. Nothing that's not perfect about it. But I'm a little bit disappointed that it didn't come with an invoice. What would you do? Would you contact Vestiaire? And maybe it has a very decent smoke scent. We don't smoke, so I'm quite good at smelling it, because if you don't smoke, you smell it a lot. If you smoke, I think you wouldn't even realize it. I don't want to be so disappointed because of the bill, because the piece is really beautiful. The seller asked for 190 euro to begin with. I think that price would have been okay since the canvas clays are already at 185 euro by now, and the leather version is always more expensive than the canvas one. We negotiated and I think I paid 160. With shipping and everything, I still paid less than the canvas ones are now brand new. It's very beautiful how the light reflects. And I already do own some key clays. There's a video on my key clay collection to come. That's the thing with me. If I like a piece, I tend to go crazy. Then I want to have it in multiple variations and it's hard for me to stop. Especially with these small pieces that are not, well, it's still a lot of money for such a small piece, but considering it's a Louis Vuitton piece and I spent under $200, that's something you can get yourself every now and then. And here I am again, Mary from the present, with her beautiful vernis patent leather key holder. I have not too much to add, I think. We saw most likely everything you need to see in an unboxing. And I think you saw as well how disappointed I've been because of the missing invoice, which is very sad because the item itself, it is so amazingly beautiful in perfect condition. And it would have deserved a happy unboxing. After I filmed the unboxing, I did contact the Vestiaire Collective and let them know that there is missing the invoice, which I thought I would get. And they offered me that I could return the piece and would get my money back, which I didn't want to do since I love it. Or the alternative would be to get 20 euro off. But unfortunately, not on this piece, but as a coupon code for my next purchase, which is not too great when you want to shop less. But it was the best I could get, and I know myself, I'm going to shop something pre-loved someday again anyways, so yeah. Having in mind that you have a coupon code, of course, makes it worse, because you want to find something you can buy, and then you keep checking the website, and the more you check the website, the more you can find, and then the more you buy, and yeah. That's not the problem of today. I filmed a little up close for you as well of the clay, so you can have a closer look. And I put a little comparison with one of the newer clays as well, which is my Damier Azur one, because this one is slightly bigger and especially in width. But if that's something you are interested in detail, I can film a separate video about the comparison of the old clay model and the new clay. I still haven't detached the tags. When I don't use an item, oftentimes I keep the tags attached on for quite long, but I wanted to show you a little close-up. It got a different zipper pull than the Louis Vuitton clay has now. And it's this beautiful, very dark red color. For comparison, here is one of the newer clays, how they are now. It is, yeah, I thought it would be wider, but it's not even that much. Oh yeah, yes it is. It is that much. And let's have a quick look inside. But yet again, it is too dark to see a lot. The clasp is the same than it is on the newer ones as well. And that's all I have for you today. Thank you so much for watching. Hope to see you next time. And bye! Ganz kurz, einen Satz müsste ich noch aufnehmen. 20 Sekunden. Okay. Then the Kayla... What's Gegenwart in English? What's now? Present. And here you will find my Louis Vuitton playlist. Since Louis Vuitton is my favorite designer brand and I'm crazy for it. Yeah, I shop Louis Vuitton every now and then, even though I try to be mindful, but sometimes I'm just talking about the brand. So if you are interested in Louis Vuitton as well, you can check it out here. And there you can subscribe.